sexual experience exceeds all expectations.
You're talking beautiful Bahamian islands, beautiful models, beautiful parties.
It was billed on social media as the cultural experience of the decade.
The most insane festival the world has ever seen.
And Mark Crawford spent thousands of dollars for tickets and anticipated the event for months.
It was all about capturing this experience of being on an island, being with this group of people. They're featuring the jet skis, and they're featuring these yachts, and they're featuring these beautiful villas.
An exclusive and curated experience on a private island in the Bahamas with luxury accommodations, gourmet food, and top musical artists like Migos, Major Lazer, and Blink 182.
It gives people that type of energy.
It was called Fyre Festival. Models and influencers like Kendall Jenner promoting it online, Bella Hadid and Emily Ratajkowski posing on white sand beaches, an Instagram fantasy come to life.
Well, I actually heard through a friend of mine. She had the whole promotional video. And then objectively, when you look at it, and we saw the package and we saw the video, it was a no-brainer.
The marketing was incredible. No one disclosed that they were ads.
Turns out the reality was far from paradise.
And what you ended up happening was consumers spent, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars and invested in a complete fraud and disaster of an event.
This is the ultimate example of following social media influencers down a dark path.
Guests who paid thousands of dollars for the ultimate luxury getaway instead were stranded in waterlogged tents eating soggy cheese sandwiches. Not a model or musical act in sight.
Right now, you are the laughing stock of everything.
The failure that is Fyre Festival, now playing out in dueling documentaries, one on Netflix, the other on Hulu, going behind the scenes with festival co-founders, musician Ja Rule, and then 25-year-old entrepreneur Billy McFarland.
I certainly made a lot of mistakes, and there's no question about that.
In 2016, McFarland teamed up with hip-hop mogul Ja Rule on a new venture, Fyre Media, a platform meant to take the middleman out of booking celebrities for events. And then, the idea for the ultimate marketing promotion.
We're gonna throw a festival, yeah.
Fyre Festival was supposed to be the new Coachella, the new Burning Man.
The event sold out, but as the days ticked on, things on the island were spinning out of control. McFarland and his team clearly over their heads.
He was unflappable, but he was also entirely delusional.
Fyre, the greatest party that never happened on Netflix, charts the festival's path from blaze of glory to burnout.
It was this constant battle in my mind between, is this guy a genius or is he a madman? Because he just would not take no for an answer, and he would not take advice.
And where do you land now?
He's a liar.
There were so many great stories from the people that were on the ground and witnessing sort of the insanity that was unfolding around them.
Chris Smith is the film's director.
There are a number of people in the documentary that are kind of raising red flags.
They were also telling people, you know, we're about to close this $20 million investment and we're about to, you know, have these sponsors come on board. So I think that there was a lot of information that was coming from Fyre that was making it seem like they were always on the verge of success.
It's April 2017 as festival goer Mark Crawford arrives. The promise of a luxe weekend starting with a private plane goes up in flames.
We land in Great Exhumant, we get off the plane, and I'm still looking for the private plane.
Oh my God.
This like yellow school bus pulls up in front of the airport, and I just thought it was like a school bus. And I remember someone at the front of the group said, no, no, we're waiting for our shuttle to Fyre Festival.
Turn around.
Their accommodations were in a gravel pit next to a sandals resort full of what appeared to be disaster relief tents.
We get there, I decide, I'm gonna save myself here, and you immediately know exactly what to do, right? Because this survival mechanism kicks in.
They brought out the luggage in two big containers, like truck containers, like 18-wheeler containers. They just said, everyone grab your bag. And it was just a frenzy.
An absolute disaster.
It became this looting mentality. One woman had a whole pallet of toilet paper. Somebody else had this whole giant box of pillows that she she was lugging back to her tent. It became very barbaric in a sense.
New details that we're learning this morning about that epic fire music festival.
Going viral with the hashtag dumpster fire.
A luxury getaway quickly spiraling into chaos.
The next day, McFarland responds to the growing outrage.
We took a big jump here and a big risk, and V1 has failed. So how we're solving this is, first, all guests have been taken home safely on planes. Next, everybody is being refunded for their ticket purchase. And then everybody is getting a comp ticket to Fyre Festival 2018.
Ultimately, McFarland was charged with defrauding investors of $27 million, telling a judge after pleading guilty to two counts of wire fraud, "I lied to investors about various aspects of Fyre Media and my personal finances," elaborating that he greatly underestimated the resources it would take to pull off an event of that scale. Charging documents stated that he provided investors with falsified financial reports, listing millions of dollars of revenue through Fyre Media, when in reality the company made less than $60,000 the year leading up to the event.
He was creating fake balance sheets. He was creating a fake net worth.
While out on bail, McFarland carried out yet another fraud. NYC VIP, which promised access to exclusive events like the Met Gala and the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show, which then led to his rearrest and two more fraud charges.
It's sort of astonishing that he's out on bail and then begins committing another fraud. You would think that the one thing he'd want to do when he's out pending trial would be stay out of trouble.
In the months that have followed, McFarland's business partner, Ja Rule, has also come under public scrutiny. The music mogul responded to criticism on Twitter, saying, "I too was hustled, scammed, bamboozled, hoodwinked, led astray."
What does going to prison look like for you?
I don't know. I haven't really gotten there yet.
McFarland is now serving a 6-year sentence in federal prison.
We didn't break the law in the execution of the festival.
What were you indicted for?
I'm not going to comment on any ongoing criminal proceedings.
But you were indicted.
I cannot comment on any ongoing criminal proceedings.
Hulu paid McFarland for this interview, a decision that Smith, the director of the Netflix documentary, had also faced.
He wanted to get paid for his participation, and in the end, we just didn't feel comfortable doing that.
But Netflix did partner with Jerry Media, the same guys who marketed the festival to millions. Smith defends that choice, saying they were independent.
We felt good about like trying to dive deep and do an objective sort of look at everything that happened, not just with Jerry Media, but with everyone that was involved. You know, Jerry Media is owed, I think, is owed over $150,000. They were trying to do their jobs, and in the end, you know, you look at all the way through to the Bahamians, to the people that were on the ground, almost everyone sort of lost.
I had 10 persons working directly with me, just preparing food all day and all night, 24 hours. I had to literally pay all those people. I am here as a Bahamian. I went through about $50,000 of my savings that I could have had for any day.
Marianne Roll has since raised more than $170,000 through a GoFundMe page.
What does that say about our society today, too, that you're able to basically have this glossy picture and people just accept it and buy in?
There's a perception versus reality that like took place in many ways.
Is it in a way, I guess, a testament to Billy's success as being a P.T. Barnum and literally getting people into the tent?
Yeah, he says it in the movie. This will be a case study that's studied, you know, in the future. And I think he's right.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.